właśnie ta oazowa pieśń wyprowadziła mnie z ojczyzny przed 23 laty. Miałem ją w uszach, kiedy słyszałem.
John Paul II's childhood home in Wadowice, Poland, is so full of beautiful details about his life that we could not pass over this city without sharing them with you. Thus, let's explore a little bit more about him from his childhood until his election as Pope.
Gotowych pójść za nim, by łowić serca słów Bożych prawdą.
Items in John Paul's apartment have many stories to tell, such as this kneeler. On this little placard, John Paul's friend from school shares a story about how they used to do homework together and how whenever they would repeat a subject, John Paul would often leave the room. One time he left the room and the door was opened, and his friend peeked in and saw him praying on this kneeler. The story behind these wooden shoes is that they are a replica of the ones John Paul would have worn as a young man, as a worker during World War II, when he worked in a stone quarry to avoid deportation by the Nazis. In 2002, while consecrating this Basilica of the Divine Mercy in Krakow, John Paul II recalled how he used to wear those shoes, and he said, "How is it possible to imagine that one day the man with the wooden shoes would consecrate the Basilica of the Divine Mercy at Wagiewniki of Krakow?" Here we see the beds of Pope John Paul and his father. John Paul testifies how, even though they never spoke of a priestly vocation, his father's witness of prayer was, for him, like a first seminary. He would often wake up at night and see his father praying at his bedside, just like he saw him praying in their parish church. An important part of John Paul's heart and person is his love for the mountains. He said, "I am a man of the mountains by birth. Though the entire Poland, every place where it is Poland, and everything that is Polish is my homeland, this part of my homeland was particularly dear to me because I was born there. I spent most of my life there. I was called to the priesthood, to the episcopate there. I was a bishop of the mountains, a cardinal from the mountains, and in the end, I became a pope from the mountains." In this picture, we see a young man altar serving for Mass for a young Father Caro Wojtyła in the woods. Known to these young people as Uncle, Wujek in Polish, so he would avoid being caught by the communist government, he would often celebrate Holy Mass with a kayak turned upside down as his altar. This is his actual kayak that we see here. The testimony of this young person, this young altar server, is powerful. He says, "Having been chosen to serve the Holy Mass said in the tent, I had the opportunity to observe the way he lived the liturgy. I sincerely admired his preparation for the Eucharist, the way he said it, as well as the thanksgiving afterwards. I saw that when he would prepare and fold altar cloths, he knelt on one knee. One could tell that he desired to be alone after Mass, so he could talk with God and thank him."
Miałem ją w uszach, kiedy słyszałem wyrok konklawy.